Hey, what's up, everyone? Raging Golden Eagle here, having way too much fun, as always. And that statement is definitely going to be holding true today, because I'm going to be taking a tongue-in-cheek, sarcastic article, though as with any sarcasm, you can kind of see hints of the author's real beliefs in there, and I'm pretty much going to be responding to it in the same way. Respond to ridiculousness with even more ridiculousness and see how ridiculous things can get. Here's the title. It's time to admit that allowing men into the workplace was a mistake. Clearly, this author is already ripping on some of the articles saying letting women into the workforce was a mistake. But let's see what kind of evidence she comes up with. The cascade of recent revelations of male workers abusing co-workers, aka Harvey Weinstein and all that, threatening subordinates and masturbating into potted plants. Okay, that one's pretty funny. I don't think I've heard that story yet. Leaves only one conclusion. The long experiment of having men in the workplace has failed. So I'm going to take that line and raise you this one. Given the cascade of recent revelations of female schoolteachers being pedophiles sleeping with their students, maybe it's about time we considered banning women from being schoolteachers. Or at the very least, stop just slapping them on the wrist every time they do it. Let's see what else they had to say. Companies run by female CEOs perform better in the stock market. Clearly working out very well for Yahoo, by the way. And women are better at both saving and investing. That one may actually be true, but for a pretty hilarious reason. I think it was Turd Flinging Monkey that originally pointed this out. Women are much more likely than men to actually listen to professional advice. Us guys, I'm not gonna lie. We often sit there thinking, ha, this is easy, I know everything. I'm not gonna spend a fortune paying someone to do what I can do myself for free. And while this does hold true for some of us, it's not necessarily true for all of us. So a lot of guys just end up effing themselves in the A with that attitude. Now going on, it's apparently 100% men who are responsible for the subprime mortgage crisis, defrauding investors, destroying hardworking people's retirement funds, and triggering worldwide economic crashes. And I'm actually pretty curious to see what sorts of excuses they'd be coming up with if it happened to be mostly women in charge when all of this is going on. And we may actually see that within our lifetimes, as I'm going to be getting into here shortly. Many male workers are also simply too emotional to thrive in the modern workplace. They struggle with anger, jealousy, and pride. They are easily distractible and prone to tantrums. Another clever reversal of what we're normally used to seeing, mind you. Even though we actually have seen plenty of examples of how male-only companies and female-only companies generally end up, I personally would actually love to see an official study on this matter. But something tells me we're not gonna get it. I noticed that academia never even kicks off studies if they know the result is going to be something they don't want to hear. Oftentimes, they convince themselves the result is going to be the exact opposite and they try to hold a study to prove it. Then when the exact opposite is revealed, they quickly brush it under the rug and pretend it didn't happen. And funny enough, that's going to be the topic of the next video, so look forward to that one. My shilling skills are top class today, aren't they? But either way, I think it would be pretty funny to end off with this. Think of all the financial and emotional damage that could have been avoided if men simply stayed home where they belong. And you know what? I agree. And it's not just me either, a growing number of men are coming to this same conclusion. Let the women take the male privilege of working themselves into an early grave, while us men take advantage of the freedoms that feminism has gifted us, and live simple, minimalist, and much happier lives. After all, as I just said, feminism has granted us true freedom. We are no longer expected by society to take care of women and provide for them. They're strong, independent, and don't need no man and can do it themselves. As such, this has lifted that burden of responsibility from our shoulders. It's no longer our responsibility or our problem to take care of these women. We are now free to go about our own lives as we see fit. And it's amazing how little money a single guy can live off of and still maintain enough to support his hobbies. I have legitimately had people that make about twice as much as me wonder how I'm so rich, because they see all the expensive toys and gadgets I'm always buying, and then they're even more shocked when I tell them, no, I'm not rich. I've simply cut costs in all other areas of my life to the bare minimum, so I can have the maximum amount of money to spend on my hobbies. The only reason I work is to support my hobbies. I'm not working out of some sense of duty to society or any of that. I'm not working to support a family, which I don't have. No, I'm working to support my hobbies. And if I didn't have these hobbies, I could easily survive working part-time if I had to. And the funniest part is, whenever I mention this to people and I give them a little window into what my life is like, Guys, when their wives aren't around at least, tend to get a little bit jealous. Women, on the other hand, they're the ones that always say it's such a waste. They're the ones that say it's so tragic. Which is kind of weird, because I'm basically giving them what they want. I'm staying out of their lives, I'm not harassing them. If I had to, I could drop out of the workforce, but I don't because I have hobbies that need supporting. These expensive waifus ain't gonna pay for themselves, you know. And most importantly, I'm actually content with my life. I'm getting more and more content with the way things are as time goes on, while women, on the other hand, at least given recent happiness studies, are just getting more and more miserable. And from that, the only thing I can conclude is, well, it looks like all those male privileges weren't all they were cut out to be, huh? But since you want them so much and feminism has freed men from the need to have them, by all means, ladies, help yourselves. And that's all I gotta say, guys. Thanks for listening.